Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be looking at calculation on vernier caliper and micrometer screw gauge. In my previous episode, we checked a look at each of these instruments, their accuracy. So we want to make use of the accuracy to calculate the readings on these instruments. Now, we are given an example above. This is an example of a vernier caliper. A vernier caliper and a micrometer screw gauge has two scales. They have the main scale, which is this scale here. They have it as the main scale. The main scale, and they have the vernier scale. The same thing to this. It has the main scale and the vernier scale. So, if one take reading on a vernier caliper, we take the reading on the main scale. At the same time, we'll be taking reading on the vernier scale. But the reading on the vernier scale is always taken using the accuracy of the instruments. Now, let's start. The question on the board said, what is the reading of the vernier scale above? The first thing is, we need to further calculate the reading on the main scale. Now, if you take a look at this main scale here, you notice that if I want to take a time 2 cm, 3 cm, the distance between these 2 cm, 3 cm, we notice we have 10 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is 10. This is a standard ruler. That means each of these values represents 0.1. If this is 2, this one should be what? 2.1. This is 2.2, 2.3, like that. The ruler is not being completed. What has been omitted from this point here is that, you know, before 2, we should have 1. So 1 has been omitted from this rule here. Now, if I want to take reading on my main scale, you need to take the reading, take the reading before the vernier scale started. This is the point where the vernier scale started. That means I need to take a reading before it. The reading before it is this reading here. This reading is before the vernier scale reading. So, what is the value of this reading here? That's all we need. So, I'll write it down that my main scale reading is equal to, normally this thing started from what? 1. I can get this, if this is 2, if I subtract, don't forget I said each of these things is 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. Now, if this one is 2, this one should be 0.1, 0.1, 0.2. Subtract 0.2 from 2 cm, I'll be getting 0.8. That is 1.8. That's what I'm going to be getting. 1.8. You know, initially, this is, because this is not completed, I can even do it like this. I know the nearest reading to it is 2 cm. My nearest reading is 2 cm. So if you know your nearest reading to be 2 cm, now, you want to know the value of this reading here. How do you know it? What is this? This is 0.1. That means 0.1. You know, I said each of them, they are 0.1. Because the distance between them is 10 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So each small point are 0.1. Now, this one here, in this case here, if I want to get the reading here, instead of for you to complete this, I can just get by saying, since here is 2, this one is 0.1, this one is 0.1. 0.1 and 0.1. 0.1 plus 0.1 makes 0.2. I will now subtract that 0.2 from the reading that is close, which is 2 cm. Now, 2 minus 0.2 will give me 1.8. That is my main scale reading. So this point here is 1.8. Here is 1.9. This one is 2.0. That means here should be 1.7. The one that are coming 1.6. This is 1.6, like that. So my main scale reading, we've known how to get that. That will be equal to 1.8 in centimeter. The next thing is for you to find our vernier scale reading. How do we find our vernier scale reading? Our vernier scale reading is always found from the vernier scale itself. This is the vernier scale. Don't forget I said the accuracy of a vernier scale is 0.01 in centimeter. If the instrument is graded in centimeter, the accuracy is 0.01 in centimeter.
Are we together?
Now, how do we now get, how do we solve for this? Since the accuracy of this instrument is 0.01 centimeter, if you want to find the reading on the vernier scale, you are going to look for the position where each of these readings, each of these small lines, touches the main scale directly, as if it is drawn from the main scale. If you check this, this one does not coincide. But if you look at this here, it is as if the line is drawn from the main scale to the vernier scale. You see this point here will be my reference point. That is our reference point. Our reference point. Now, this is my reference point. Then, I will now start my reading from what? The second point. This one, this point here, there is a gap. This point here is the gap between each of these is counted. This one here, this point here, this is 0.01, which is the accuracy in centimeter. This point is 0.01, this one is 0.02, this one is 0.02, 0.03, 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07, 0.08, and this one, you are going to count it as 0.09. Why am I counting this? The reason why I'm counting this is because I'm not touch. I took this as my reference point, then I started my count for the next. So if I'm in my reference point, here is my 0.01, 0.02, 0.03, 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07, 0.08, and 0.09. So the vernier scale reading is 0.09. Then I will now add the total reading on the two instruments will now be on the two scale will now be equal to addition of this plus this. This is in centimeter. If I add this plus this, I'll be having 1.89 centimeter. That is the reading on the vernier scale. Let's jump into the what? Micrometer screw gauge. The same way you calculated the vernier scale, that's how we calculate a micrometer screw gauge. How do we calculate that? This thing is in millimeter, not in centimeter. Now, it said from the diagram above, the measuring accuracy of the micrometer screw gauge is, don't forget I said, each of these instruments, they have the main scale and the vernier scale. This is the vernier scale for a micrometer screw gauge. Don't forget, the accuracy of this scale, of this vernier scale of a micrometer screw gauge is 0.01 in millimeter. 0.01 in millimeter. Now, I'm going to take a reading on this, and I'm going to take a reading on this. How do we take the reading? Now, this one is 0 millimeter. This is the first line here, the first big line here. This one denotes 1 millimeter. This one is 2 millimeter. This one is 3 millimeter. This is 3.5. Then you see this line itself recounted. This line is here. That is 4 millimeter. This is 4 millimeter. So the reading on the main scale reading is equal to 4 mm. Now, what about the vernier scale? The vernier scale reading will be equal to what? How do we get that one? You go to this point here. You see all this line here? You are going to look for where the line coincides with this line, this straight line here. Where does all this line, which one touches it directly from this line, as if it is drawn from this line to this point. If you check everything, you notice that this one is drawn like that. Have you? Now, this line here is 15. Then this one here should be what? 16. Because this thing is counted 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Look at it. This is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. This is 15. Automatically, this one will be 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. You see? So, this one, this line that it touches, that this line here is 16. What will I do? You now multiply that 16, this 16, multiply with the accuracy of this vernier scale. Accuracy is 0.01 in millimeter. So if I multiply it with 16, that means for my vernier scale, I'll be having 0.01 in millimeter times 16. I'll be having 0.16. That is why we have 0.16 mm. 0.16 mm. That is what reading of the vernier scale. Now, after you've gotten the reading of the vernier scale, please don't forget this. And you've gotten the reading of the main scale, then add the two readings together. Your total reading will now be equal to my main scale, which is 4, plus my vernier scale, which is 0.16. Everything into mm. Then I'll be having my reading to be equal to 4.16 mm. That is the reading in the micrometer screw gauge. Please take your pen, jot down this, and jot down this. In your next exam, when you see question on this, try to be able to solve that. Thank you for watching this my video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell to receive a new notification whenever I release a video. And please try to click on the like button to like my video. Thanks. See you in my next episode.